last selection on side two, the last of the album, is called The End. And this was all recorded live in the studio, no overdubs whatsoever. And here we go.
This is the end, beautiful friend. This is the end, my only friend, the end.
This is the end, you know, like, what's he talking about? You know, do people write about, is he writing about death? Do people do that in a song? That's nothing like obla-di-obla-da. What's going on?
The End actually started out as a love, a love song, a goodbye love song. This is the end, beautiful friend. And Jim sang it to us a cappella, and we kind of went, whoa, okay, that's dark. And the whole long 10-minute middle section of poetry and all that stuff kind of evolved playing live. And we had sections where he could put in whatever he wanted while we would vamp.
At the Whiskey A Go-Go, Jim came up with this great part. And we'd never heard it before. It's the first time he ever did this. On stage, Whiskey A Go-Go, packed. And he had that aura about him that had just stopped the entire place. Everything had gone into just frozen moment in time. Nothing was going on except this. Densmore's drums and Robbie playing some sitar things, and Morrison says, "The killer awoke before dawn." Oh God, what is he gonna do? He put his boots on. He took a face from the ancient gallery and he walked on down the hallway, baby.
And you die. Father, yes, son. Kill you. Mother, I want to
not what you all thought.
It was so seductive, the quietness of the beginning and how it erupts into some kind of Oedipal craziness at the end. And it was dynamic, it was drama of very, very high order.
You know, the end is Oedipus Rex, you know, it's Freud, it's the Oedipal complex, it's full of darkness.
Come on, baby, come on, you gotta fuck me, baby, fuck yeah.
Of course, originally we had to mix that down, but it's rhythmically part of it. It's an instrument, you know.
you wouldn't find this on Ferry Across the Mersey or whatever. I mean, this is like a 10-minute drone, no snares, moody seance.
You can sense that they were experimenting, and that you need that from true artists. You need them to reach in and say, you know, this, I don't know if this is ugly, I don't know if this is odd, but here it is, I find it kind of beautiful.